Federal funding for Hurricane Sandy recovery is supporting construction of a 20,950-foot living shoreline project at Glen L. Martin National Wildlife Refuge's Fog Point to help protect the coast of Smith Island from erosion and sea level rise. The refuge encompasses more than 4,500 acres of wetland and upland habitat on Chesapeake Bay Islands, including the northern half of Smith Island, located west of Crisfield, Maryland, between Tangier Sound and the Chesapeake Bay. The tidal marsh, coves, creeks, and ridges of the refuge provide an important rest area and winter home for thousands of migratory waterfowl. These natural areas also provide nesting habitat for resident birds, such as brown pelicans, black skimmers, oyster catchers, and black ducks. This living shoreline project, led by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, will also enhance the natural defenses of saltwater habitats important to fish and wildlife species, as well as Smith Island's softshell crab fishery, a natural resource the local residents of Smith Island depend upon.
Martin National Wildlife Refuge is about 4,400 acres. It's the northern part of Smith Island, and one of the things that really makes Martin Refuge and Smith Island such a remarkable place is the quality of the habitat that we have out here. So this project we're doing through Hurricane Sandy is about a 20,000-foot living shoreline project, and that what that'll do is effectively protect the western and northwestern shoreline of Martin Refuge from erosion. They're placing rock for headland control structures, they're placing sand to restore intertidal marsh that's eroded away due to shoreline erosion, and this is really one of the most important projects that's taken place here on Martin Refuge. The town of Yule, immediately over here to our south, one of three communities still on Smith Island, mostly watermen, and these shallow waters that we're protecting through this project not only directly protect the community, but also protect some of the submerged aquatic vegetation beds that they fish for crabs.
My name is Eddie Evans. I'm a lifelong resident of Smith Island. I've been a waterman all my life. Right where they're working now, that cove was about to be completely exposed to the bay. And that was going to fill this cove up with sand, where the grass don't grow. And if you don't have any grass, not only aren't you going to be able to feed the ducks with the grasses, the crabs are not going to have a place to protect themselves.
I'm thankful for the project that's going on right now, first of all. It's a great project. We stand behind it the whole way. It's something that's coming, I believe, as a waterman, I believe it is coming to help save some of our habitat, which we work directly into the habitat. We work into bay grasses that grow and around the shorelines, and I believe it's going to help this tremendously.
So one of our main goals of this project is not just to protect the intertidal marsh, but to protect the large areas of shallow, sheltered water where these guys scrape for crabs. And so the soft crab industry is really the economic heart of Smith Island. So, you know, the soft crab sandwich that you may be enjoying in Baltimore or Philadelphia could have come from, you know, Back Cove or the Big Thoroughfare, some of these areas that we're protecting through this Hurricane Sandy project.